Hi, hello and welcome again to another edition of Sports Update Ghana. My name is Joseph Adamafiu, and coming up in this edition, we'll be looking at two players of Ghanaian descent who featured in the 2022 FIFA World Cup in the game between Wales and USA. I'm talking about Ethan Ampadu, who plays for the Welsh national team, as well as Yunus Musah, who plays for the United States of America. They were all in action as Timothy Weah scored for United States of America, whilst Gareth Bale got the equalizer. We all know how the game ended, but did you know about the players of Ghanaian descent who featured in the match? Well, we'll talk about that more extensively here on Sports Update Ghana. But first, please subscribe to the channel, like, share, and don't forget to leave a comment. So, like I said, the United States of America took on Wales in their first game in the 2022 FIFA World Cup, and the match ended 1-1. Well, the match started with Timothy Weah, the son of George Weah, the president of Liberia, scoring the first goal for the United States of America in the 35th minute as he picked up a nice pass from his teammate and just slotted it to him to score the first goal in the game for the United States. Well, Timothy Weah, who is the son of George Weah, we all know his father, the only African to have won the Ballon d'Or in history. And whilst his father is the president of Liberia, Timothy Weah prefers to play for the American team. Well, later on in the game, in the 90th minute, that is when Gareth Bale got the equalizer for Wales from the spot kick, as Wales were awarded a penalty in the game, and that was how Wales were able to pull parity in the game for the match to end 1-1. But one of the key highlights in the game was how two players of Ghanaian descent ended up featuring for both sides of the team that played in the match between USA and Wales. For Wales, they featured Ethan Ampadu, as the name sounds Ghanaian. Well, Ethan Ampadu is a son of a Ghanaian father, but his mother is Welsh, and that's how come Ethan Ampadu plays for the Welsh national team. For Yunus Musah, he is a Ghanaian fully, because both parents, mother and father, are all Ghanaians, but Yunus Musah opted to play for United States of America. Now let me break it down over here. So for Ethan Ampadu, he had the opportunity to either play for the Welsh national team, I think, as well as the English national team, Belgium and Ghana. Well, he ended up choosing the Welsh national team, and after playing at the so Ethan Ampadu was born to a Ghanaian father but a Welsh mother, and this is his full name, Ethan Kwame Kom Raymond Ampadu. He was born on September 14, 2000, and is a footballer and plays as a centre back as well as a defensive midfielder, and currently plays for Spezia in the Serie A. And that is Ethan Ampadu over there. He's currently on loan at Spezia from Chelsea. He has been playing for Chelsea for quite a long time, since 2017, since he joined Chelsea. He has been on loan for several years. He played for England at the youth level at the under 16, but unfortunately he later switched to play for the Welsh national team in the under 17, under 19, and was promoted to the senior team of Wales. And in this particular match, he did very well. What about Yunus Musah? What do we know about Yunus Musah? Yunus Musah played a fine game for USA in this particular game, but what do we know about Yunus Musah? Yunus Musah was born as Yunus Damiara Musah on November 29th, 2002, so he'll be turning 20 years in a couple of days. Musah was eligible to play for either the US, Ghana, Italy and England, but the player opted to play for the United States ahead of his parent country, that is Ghana. Well, he was raised up in Italy and also had the opportunity to also grow up in England, but when it came to the choosing of which country to represent, well, he decided to represent the United States of America. Well, he was born in the United States to a Ghanaian parent, and well, he grew up mostly in Italy and England. As I have said, he was a youth international for England before committing to play for the United States of America. So that is how come these two players end up playing for two different countries whilst they are all Ghanaians. And This often happens. We've lost a number of players in the first game of the 2022 FIFA World Cup. I told you about how Mohamed Muntari plays for the Qatari national team as well over there. So it looks like as the game goes on, each and every day, we have players playing for different countries. In fact, in the Netherlands game, we also saw Cody Gakpo scoring the first goal of the tournament for Netherlands in the game. But how did these two players perform, Ethan Ampadu and Yunus Musah? For Ethan Ampadu, this was how he performed. He played 89 minutes of action before he was substituted and had 61 touches on the ball. His passing accuracy was 68%. His long balls were 8. He had one shot off target and dribbled past one player. His grounded duels were 6. He had 3 aerial duels, 15 possession loss, committed one foul and was fouled twice and made 3 clearances in the game and blocked one shot and one interception. And that is how Ethan Ampadu performed in the game. For Yunus Musah, well, he played 75 minutes of action before he was substituted. He had 51 touches on the ball and had a passing accuracy of 91%. He had one key pass in the game, one cross and one long ball, and well, he never recorded a shot on target despite creating chances in the game for his teammates. Well, he dribbled past two players, had 6 grounded duels, 2 aerial duels, lost possession 7 times and was fouled once and committed also one foul. And that is how Yunus Musah performed in this particular game for United States. But the man of the match in this particular encounter for the United States of America was none other but Timothy Weah, the son of George Weah. And for him, this was how he performed. He played 88 minutes of action before he was substituted. One goal and had one shot on target, 34 touches on the ball, 88 passing accuracy and one key pass in the game. His crosses were 3, long balls were 3, one grounded duels, 3 aerial duels and committed one offside in the game. And that is how Timothy Weah performed in the game for United States as they drew 1-1 with Wales as Gareth Bale scored the equalizer for Wales to end the match 1-1. So yes, that is it for this episode of Sports Update Ghana. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Has Ghana tried enough in getting players to switch nationalities to play for the Black Stars? We've been able to capture a few players. What about the rest? Well, I think we have to do more and get more players to play for the Black Stars. My name is Joseph Adamafiu, and it was nice coming your way with a sports update. Thanks for watching.